Today, all of us have visited or maybe even still visit things that we have come to call as malls. Every city and now increasingly even rural areas are proud to have for themselves a mall. And we regard this as a great solution to our problem of having to shop in multiple places. So we say that we have progressed and we have become modern the minute we have a large mall or several large malls which come up in our city. Interestingly, if you look at the 1980s again, you will see that the predominant way in which we shopped was we went to different locations in our little town in order to get different things. So if we wanted vegetables, we went to the Sabji Mandi. If we wanted clothes, we went to Lakshmi Road. If we wanted hardware, we went to Boriyadi. We had different locations for going and getting different things. And we went to these places not on a weekly or a daily basis. And we didn't go there to buy one, get one free. But we went there because there was a rhythm to when we needed to go there. So if you remember that in those years, it was probably once a year that we went for shopping for clothes, just during Diwali. It was not when the mall was running a sale. If you recall, it was probably once a month that the local grocer got a list from, your mother or whoever was the lady of the house about what was required for the month, and only that which was required for the month would get ordered to last for the month, and the wastage was almost zero wastage. Now I guess it's probably more than once a week that one would go to the local supermarket, which would probably be in the mall, and of course there are deals happening on several things. So you end up having more than what you want to consume, even for the whole month, brought in every week. And a few months down the road or few years down the road, this is stuff which is going out into the waste, or it is given away, if you are more fortunate. So suddenly we have become, we have increased our consumption several fold in the last 25 or 30 years. And if you just want to look at it in terms of numbers, then somewhere from a 9 trillion rupee market, the retail industry has grown to become a 50 trillion rupee market from 2000 to 2017. So in 2000, it was a 9 trillion rupee market already. And in 2017, it's a 50 trillion rupee market. Yes, of course, our politicians tell us this is great because GDP is growing. Once you consume a lot more, the GDP increases. And they say, well, this is what is good for the economy. And of course, in the same breath, we see that the waste that we are generating has grown more than 100-fold. And if you look at the city of Pune, it is not able to handle the waste that it has to deal with because there is no place to throw it away to. And I think it is for the umpteenth time that the people of Devachi Urali have said that we are not going to allow you to throw any more waste into our backyard. And Pune still has to find a solution. So in some ways, we keep searching for a place to throw away the waste to, but we have forgotten that the problem of today is from the solution of yesterday, the malls that we built and the retail industry that we have caused to grow and the buy one, get one free culture that we have brought into our lifestyle, where instead of saying that we can be as frugal as possible and consume only what we need, we have just assumed that the next new mobile version is what I need to have. That I need to upgrade my vehicle every second year or third year instead of the hand-me-down vehicle which used to exist. And even in our own houses, we probably do more interior renovations than we used to do 30 years ago. So every 3 years or 5 years, we probably want a new look, which we did not want maybe, 30 years ago. So I think somewhere the solutions of yesterday have become the problems of today. So the third example that I want to go to is this great energy demand that has happened in our country, and it's happened world over. So if we look at the world, we are increasingly consuming more and more energy. We somehow said that, look, all our problems can be eased if we somehow have a device which can do it for us, and that device will consume energy. So we shifted to an era of automating everything, even what can be done manually. Right from the way we wash our clothes, to the way we wash our dishes, and to the way in which we cool our houses. So we started off with saying that, look, the city of Pune, for example, is getting warmer in summers, so we need to have ceiling fans. I remember in my childhood, we had no ceiling fans, we had no table fans, and we didn't need them. And the first time that somebody got a pedestal fan in the house, everybody would come and have a look at it and say, wow. But it used to be used very frugally. That gave way to assuming today that an AC is essential in summers. In some ways, this has helped us to just forget the fact that those trees that we had in the city of Pune were the ones which actually cooled our city. Now, because I can control the temperature in my room by fixing an air conditioner, I don't have to care about whether Pune has more trees or less trees. I've just given up caring about it, right? Because I can now use energy in order to cool my premises and throw out the heat from this room to the exterior to make the exterior more hot. And the more of us doing that, we make the city even warmer. And as we remove those trees, because we say progress means we need to transport ourselves a lot more, and therefore we need to build a lot more roads, and roads must have priority over the cooling of the city. And therefore it has to be progress by removing those trees and cementing them. So where there were tarred roads, we say that let's cement them, and we forget the fact that concrete is going to retain much of the solar radiation that is incident on the city and make it even more warmer, and also ensure that the rain which used to penetrate into Pune's soil and keep the soil moisture, allowing the city to cool down, can no longer help the city to cool down. So, as a consequence, our heat cooling needs for the city of Pune and similarly rest of India have grown enormously. So, as a consequence, all these solutions that we gave for solving our problem of cooling have resulted in the problem of today. So now, what are we proposing? Well, it's all right for us to use the ACs. It's all right for us to use all our washing machines and all the other devices. Let's start using renewables. So we are trying to solve the problem by saying that we will have renewables, but let us continue to use more energy in our life. every activity that we do today is far more energy intensive than it was 30 years ago. So somewhere we are still forgetting the fact that even if we make our renewable component grow, there is a 7 or 8% growth of energy demand that exists in this country annually. So at a 7 or 8% increase in the renewable in the energy demand, in the primary energy demand, even if the renewables grow at the aggressive target that the government has set, and as they claim, by 2022, we have 175 megawatts, gigawatts, of capacity, and that is about 40% of our total. We will still be having non-renewables, which are used more than we are using today, because our total primary energy demand has grown at 7% or 8% per annum. So, in a sense, renewables are still not going to solve our problem unless we actually reduce the energy consumption that we have in our day-to-day activities. Everything, all the automation that we have, all the manufacturing that we do, all the lifestyle that we are building, all the lighting that we are doing, all the transportation that we are doing, it's all consuming the energy. And we need to think about how are we going to actually reduce our energy demand. It's not about substituting our energy from non-renewables to renewables alone that's going to solve our problem.